FEM-Design 3D Structure is the complete 3D module where any structure can be modeled from scratch or imported from Revit as a true XML file. The FEM-Design interface is very modern and designed to be as intuitive as possible. Let's begin with the main tabs. FEM-Design has a modular structure. All the tabs up to Analysis make up the main calculation engine. Here you can define your geometry, set up your loads, define the mesh, and run the calculation, from which you will get the deformation and internal forces distribution. After that, the design modules are added: foundation design, RC design, steel design, and timber design. The order of the tabs follows the suggested flow of design, meaning that it is recommended to try to move from left to right. The first tab is the structure tab, where we mainly define the geometry of the structure. Here it is possible to create stories and axes, define the soil and foundation, the bar elements, the shell elements, and set our supports. Apart from the essential geometry tools, we have the special FEM-Design modeling tools and covers, which can be used to create and simulate different types of structural behaviors. For example, the point-point connection may be used to determine the forces in the bolts of a steel connection. And the cover can be used to distribute surface loads to the supporting structure. The arrow in the text box underneath each section will allow you to expand or collapse that tab. Clicking the text will direct you automatically to the settings of that element. The next tab is the load tab. It is here where we can define the load cases, load groups, and load combinations. The forces can be applied on the structure as point, line, and surface loads. It is also possible to set temperature variation loads and stress loads. The support motion loads can be useful when dealing with settlements and analyzing how they will affect the structure. It is in the dynamic load section where you can set or convert masses and define your seismic load. The macro loads are special FEM-Design functions that generate loads automatically according to your input. In the case of the wind macro, not only will the surface loads from the wind be created and applied on the model, but load cases will be defined for X and Y directions. It is also possible to define deviation, notional, and moving loads. The latest tools are the import-export loads, which allow you to manipulate your loads from an external file, like an Excel sheet. The Finite Elements tab allows you to manipulate the finite element mesh, and is one of the main strengths in FEM-Design. The peak smoothing function allows you to create areas of distribution for peak values in a plate, giving a more realistic result for your forces and reducing the amount of reinforcement required. The Analysis tab is where we run the calculation and see the results. You can perform different types of calculations, including stability analysis, eigenfrequencies, and seismic analysis. Furthermore, you can perform plastic calculations, second-order analysis, and cracked section analysis. The next four tabs are the design tabs. Here you can perform code checks and have the possibility to do an auto design or a manual design. You can design the reinforcement in the concrete elements. Check the steel elements, steel connections, and fire design, and design the timber elements, all with detailed calculations and reports. These reports can be added to the documentation module. Here you can create your own documentation report or use a predefined template. It is also possible to create your own templates and use them in future projects as well. Results can be generated and listed here in the form of graphical windows, tables, drawbox, text box, and images. The toolbars are located on the left and on the right side of the screen and can be moved and replaced on any of the four edges. You can also add or remove tools at any time by right-clicking on the menu and selecting which options you want displayed. Let's take a look at the drawing area. There are some default mouse actions that allow for an easy navigation through the 3D model. Right-clicking on the drawing area will open the Modify tools. Click and dragging the wheel button will let you pan along the model. While holding the Control key, you can click the wheel button to rotate the view around the center point of the screen. The same action using the Alt key will let you rotate around any point on the screen. Double-clicking the wheel button will fit the model on the screen view. There are several ways to select objects in the drawing area. If you use the right-to-left box sweep selection, everything that intersects and is included in the box will be selected. Similarly, from left to right, only the elements that are completely enclosed in the selection box will be selected. To select a specific element, you right-click on it and that element will be highlighted. You can modify it and edit its properties. Holding the Control key will allow you to perform a multiple selection. While in the properties of a specific element, you can use Control A and all the elements of that type will be selected. There are two coordinate systems in FEM-Design. The global coordinate system, which is fixed, and is indicated by the three thin arrows, green for X, red for Y, and blue for Z direction. The other coordinate system is the user coordinate system, illustrated by the thick green and red arrows, and it can be modified from the user coordinate system function in the view menu. Let's take a look at the status bar. The exact position of the cursor crosshair is indicated at all times by the X, Y, Z coordinates. You can define the exact coordinates of a point when trying to draw or model an element by typing in the values separated by the comma. The three values will represent the X, Y, and Z coordinates. When defining a beam, for example, you select the beam tool, choose define, and the status bar will tell you what action it is expecting you to perform. Right now, I can see that I have to enter the coordinates of the first point of my straight line. I can do that either by clicking on the drawing area or by typing in my exact coordinates for X, Y, and Z, and pressing Enter. You can keep track of what you have to do next by checking the status bar, as now it is waiting for my endpoint input. You can also switch from orthogonal system to cylindrical system by clicking the small symbol beside the coordinates. In FEM-Design, all elements are grouped in layers. The status of each layer varies from hidden, protected, and active, depending on the tab you are in. For example, when in the Loads tab, all the structural layers will be in protected mode. This is to ensure that you do not alter the structure by mistake when dealing with loads. Of course, any layer can be activated or hidden at any point manually. When protected, the elements in that layer will be visible, but you will not be able to modify them.